Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin explored the moon in July 1969 on the Apollo 11 mission, one of the greatest technological achievements of the 20th century. Armstrong passed away in August 2012.
Soon after Neil Armstrong died, his widow contacted us and said that she found a white bag, this bag in one of his closets, opened it up, and sure enough, inside was some spacecraft parts or things that she didn't exactly know what they were. Immediately, this bag was recognizable. We knew exactly what it was. It was what's called McDivitt's purse. McDivitt had been an Apollo 9 astronaut who said, we need a place to stow stuff as we're working. So our priority was to review each and every item and convince ourselves with photographic and other evidence that these were actually flown on the Apollo 11 mission, which landed the astronauts on the moon. In the case of the bag, if you look very, very, very closely, you can see very, very faintly on the bag a sort of a ghost serial number, 0014. And so by finding this sort of ghost serial number on this, it really helped us in our authentication. We realized that what we really did is had Apollo 11's purse.
And it's always really interesting to me to see things that came back from lunar missions, to examine their condition, what kind of evidence would be on the materials from actually being used in service on the moon. A good example of that is the clamps, which are on the table here in front of us. They wanted to find out if they had been attached to a yellow handrail or rail in the lunar module, and if there were paint flakes on the clamp that would prove that. And there were, in the jaws of the clamp. I think the most exciting thing about this project is collaborating with you on those stories, because if I had just found paint on the tether, on the surfaces of the metal, I wouldn't have known where to link that to or what its use could have been. That wraps around the scientific evidence that we're finding with the stories that you've been told.
The first display of objects from this collection, the data acquisition camera and waste tether, was in a 2015 temporary exhibition.
The astronauts would have to make a choice on several things. One, things that meant something very personal to them, and that's very interesting to speculate. The other thing that had to be easily separated. In other words, they had to have little plugs that could have been unplugged from the lunar module. They had to have been small, and they had to not take up too much room or be too heavy.
So this netting was used on the wall of the LEM to keep items from floating around or to secure items. Alan, the curator, had asked me to look at it more closely because there was a story behind this indicating that one of the astronauts may have stepped on it with his boot when he came off the lunar surface and before he changed his overshoes. And sure enough, when I looked at the dark staining at one end of the net, it did indicate that there is lunar dust ground into the surfaces of the object. And not only that, that invisible to the naked eye, there's lunar dust practically spread all over it. You just don't see it except in the very dark spot where it was ground into the fibers. So the waste port cover is actually my favorite object just because it's more utilitarian and less personal. They did use it in the ship, and it would have gone on the cover where the waste was exported out of the LEM.
Each of them has its own story. One of the most interesting is that this wrench would have been used had there been an accident or a contingency where the lunar module could not have docked with the command module, and the astronauts would have had to float over doing a spacewalk to get inside. So to think that they had thought of that possibility and provided a tool that could be used in that way is just one of the fascinating stories about almost each and every one of these objects.
Yeah, and it's really remarkable that these objects survived for 40 plus years intact in his closet, and they're in excellent condition.
We already had most of the stuff we thought we would ever get about the Apollo program, so this was just a tremendous opportunity. I think it helps us sort of connect in a human way with people who have become almost sort of iconic or historical figures rather than human beings.